You've seen her comedy concerts in all the big cities, like Zorro, Ohio at the Elks Lodge, at bingo halls in Stockholm, Wisconsin, and working the retirement home in Louisiana, Missouri. And now you hear her thoughts on her No Reason podcast. Here's Nola J, the chocolate blonde, on the No Reason podcast.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Welcome to the No Reason podcast. That is being taken over by the Generation Gap. It's a new series that we're doing on the No Reason podcast, and it's called the Generation Gap, and I will be one of the participants, Nola J, a.k.a. Chocolate Blonde, a.k.a. Jizzle.
You got enough names, Jizzle? Just... And I'm your co-host, Don Suave, a.k.a. Young Suave Sutra, a.k.a. I'm not Donic with the tonic today, but, you know, you just call me...
Moosehead. I'm just calling you Moosehead. You're Moosehead.
I don't know what that means.
Well, that's where you were Chocolate Moose the other day.
I was Chocolate Moose the other day. And we have a third co-host in our generation gap. We're bridging the generation between the young and not so young, but still young.
I don't know. Pops, could you introduce yourself? That's your son.
Well... I'm just, I don't have a whole lot of names, just Kenny Walker. I have been known as Kenny International. Well, when I lived in L.A., they called me the Big K of L.A., but I told them I was Milwaukee. I was Kenny from Milwaukee, but you could just call me Kenny International, I guess.
Okay, well, we gonna get this started. The reason we call it Generation Gap, at one point, each one of us had a gap in our front teeth. They're gone. I don't know what happened. They closed.
I still got mine.
You know you don't. You're holding on. You're holding on to a slither. It's a slither.
It's a gap, though.
It's a slither. So we all had it at one point. Pops is a baby boomer. Swizzle Suave Moosehead is a millennium. And I'm Generation X. So for this first episode, we're going to discuss our top five basketball players of all time. Dad, before we started this podcast, we was having a discussion on how we're going to do this. So, Dad, was you saying you think yours is better than ours?
I picked a team, and being a baby boomer, I could have just picked baby boomer players. I mean, the oldest players, but they weren't baby boomers. So, I'm going to just pick the best team. I think if I had to bet my life, my mansion, and all my estate on... I would bet on this team that I have assimilated, and I dare anybody to come up with a team, and you can have all the rest of the players you
want.
All the
rest of the players. So, essentially, this is a draft that you get the first five picks.
Yeah, he gets the first five picks, and we don't get anything. We got to figure out how to beat his team.
Well, plus the first man off the bench.
So six.
Six. I got a six.
See? Now, baby boomers
I do have the rest of my squad laid out, but I'm not going to bother you with that because there's some guys on there that you probably won't pick anyway because you don't know basketball like I know basketball.
But I don't know if I can really trust you because you've changed the greatest player three times in the last 30 seconds of
That's
us
just
speaking
the thing.
Earlier.
I recognize greatness.
Every 30 seconds?
And most people just recognize Michael Jordan, and that's it. They stop there, but... I recognize greatness.
So let's do the draft, and then
we'll
after
do the draft. And also,
let's debate the greatest of all time.
Okay,
we're just
you
gonna
guys,
let you, Dad. We're gonna let you have this because it's Father's Day.
Okay,
but we're not necessarily saying you have the best team. Okay.
Well, if it's Father's Day, why can't I have everything?
No, you can't. You can. Well,
okay. Okay. Look,
got a lot going on over there, Poppy.
I'm gonna list my team.
Okay.
And then you guys could try. To find some guys that can beat these guys.
Wow.
All
well
right. We're going to start off with probably the greatest basketball player of all time. It was definitely one of them.
Wait, real quick before you start. What are we going to... You have...
I'm gonna list my team.
I know, but you have Swizzles in our team as well on your piece of paper, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I just want to make sure so you can read ours when you're done with your.
Okay, my documentation is all straightforward.
Let's go with the documentation then.
I don't see anything in front of your desk.
He's documented. He's a documented black man. Go ahead.
Okay, I got Magic Johnson at point guard.
At point guard, okay.
Shooting guard. Forward, power forward.
All five positions.
And all five positions.
And you guys, the person in the background is our sister. Oh. Say hi, Kim.
Hi, Kim.
A.K.A. Tuki.
A.K.A. Apple.
A.K.A. K-Dot.
Okay, I got
A.K.A.
Kevin.
A.K.A. little sister.
Kevin Durant.
Kevin Durant, he's running the three.
He's point guard, off guard. Forward.
You like Kevin Durant? Okay.
And I got Hakeem. Olajuwon.
Okay.
And he's running the...
He's forward? Or what are you doing?
He's forward. And depending on who you pick, he could be the center.
Okay.
You know. He's versatile.
Right.
And I got this other guy, Kobe Bryant.
Yeah.
He's just Kobe Bryant.
Yeah, we don't need to debate on that one.
He's playing
Kobe was on all of our teams.
Okay.
RP to the bean.
And for center, I have Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, the guy with the most points of all time in basketball, and six NBA championships, just like that other guy, Jordan. And coming off the bench... I have Wilt Chamberlain.
So you got Wilt coming off the bench.
What?
Okay, now.
What?
I want you to put
He was one of the greatest players 30 seconds ago.
So he's a role player.
But but my bench player is not a bench player.
That's obvious.
I might have him start. I might have Hakeem coming off the bench. I might have Kareem coming off the bench.
You just make up your own rules with this.
I mean, yeah, this is how you run a team.
Okay.
If you go by the rules, you'll never get ahead. Okay. So, I challenge you to put a team together that could even compete.
Well, can you tell me who I had on my team, please?
Okay, so Jizzle.
Okay, now.
Jizzle's team.
All right. Nola J. said she picked a team that could beat my team. Now, don't everybody start laughing, okay?
I got a good team.
All right. She starts off with Michael Jordan.
Duh.
So Michael is running the two?
Michael is, he's the point. He's mm-hmm. the two. So, he's the forward.
So he's guarding Magic. Because I'm looking at the matchup. I want to look at the matchup.
Well,
so.
Why don't you let me give the whole team?
Yeah, let's get the whole
first,
team.
Because you don't know how you can match up by one.
Because he got Will Chambers as a bench player, so we never know what's going to happen.
Okay, she's got Tim Duncan.
Okay.
She's got...
That's my forward.
Dr. J.
I love me some Dr. J.
Dr. J, okay.
Giannis, who's this?
Giannis. Guinness. That German guy. It's the new German guy on the Milwaukee Bucks.
Okay. She's got Giannis.
Makes sense.
Of course I got Giannis.
And with my influence, she has Dennis Johnson.
Is that my sixth guy, right?
Johnson. You still got another guy.
I'm talking about Dennis Rodman.
Dennis Rodman. I'm sorry.
I was going to say, I didn't put no freckle face Dennis Rodman.
Which she completely forgot about until I had him on one of my... I had him on my squad for the rest of my team, but I let her have
him. It's his day. It's Padre's day.
So she scratched one of her guys. I'm not going to tell you who she scratched. Oh, she scratched Iceman. She put him on six-man.
Iceman coming off the bench.
Yeah.
Iceman coming off the bench.
I got a good squad.
Yeah, she kind of wanted Bill Russell, but she went with Iceman.
I like Ice.
Okay.
So she's
got Michael Jordan.
Well, I have to have Kobe in there. There's no way I miss Kobe.
I have Kobe.
Well, he's been
okay,
taken.
So...
Oh, he took...
Okay. She's got Michael Jordan. She's got Tim Duncan, Dr. J, Giannis, Dennis Rodman, Iceman against Magic, Kevin Durant, Hakeem, Kobe, Kareem, Wilt Chamberlain.
That's not fair. You took everybody.
So who's running the point on your team? Somebody's got to bring the ball up the court, you know.
I know.
Not turn the ball over.
I would have loved to have my Kobe. I can't have Kobe.
Okay, let's not go about coulda, woulda. You have.
So I would have to.
You got the Iceman.
You had to do.
I got Iceman. Giannis would have to. He'd have to switch
point.
Over. He could do it.
He plays the point. He could do it. So you got to have Giannis.
Okay, so you're putting down Giannis as your point.
So we got. It's basically gonna be Giannis on Magic.
No, wait, you're not telling me who I'm going to put on who?
No,
I'm
hold on. Her team. But we got to get Swizzles. We got to get Suave's team.
Oh, stop me.
I mean.
Okay, who you want to.
We're not going to win. So why are we even doing this?
Okay. So you're going to have Giannis guarding who?
Well, you got to go Giannis at point because nobody else is really
no one is okay. No one else because you took
that's your decision.
Okay. Even though, fun fact, Jordan ran the point 1 year.
It could be between Jordan and Giannis.
He averaged 11 assists.
I can see them 30 swapping. Points. But what was Suave's team?
I'll give you a little advice, fellas.
And I'm a lady.
Don't
lady.
I didn't transition or anything.
Okay. All right. I had on my reading glasses. I couldn't see a fire.
What'd you see? Two and Suave?
Just look at that.
Okay. In the background, we have Magic playing. So it's a distraction right now, which I'm about to turn this off because you are distracted. Our dad, it's his day. We let him do whatever he want to do.
You got Hakeem, too.
So we're watching.
Okay, so let's get back to these matchups.
Okay.
So we got Giannis and Magic, right? If I'm looking at
you
that.
You got Giannis guarding Magic. Okay, that's what you want to do.
We ain't got no choice. Then, you done took everybody.
Okay. All right, then what?
And then we got to go probably Jordan on Kobe.
Okay.
That's going to be a wash, basically. Depending on the rules.
Well, dad's rules, probably.
Play baby boomer era.
Right, so who knows?
Then it'll definitely be.
Okay, who's Dr. J guarding?
You got to put Dr. J on Durant.
Yeah.
Oh, that's going to be.
I think. But you know what? So far, I mean, I don't know. Giannis and Magic, that's a little.
That's a nice little.
Tough.
That's nice.
That'd be tough for Magic, because Giannis.
Yeah.
You ain't.
Y'all got to realize now. We're talking each player in a prime.
Yeah.
Time that I mean at the top of their game.
We're not talking about Magic in retirement during the 80s.
Well, I mean that's what it sounds like. We got Giannis on Magic. I mean, first of all, in his prime, I mean he's a point guard. He's not supposed to shoot the ball, right? You know that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, what is Giannis doing?
Defense.
Yeah, but I mean, what is he defending? A pass?
He got to do. Yeah, he can.
Well, you got to get to a spot to make the right pass.
Right, and have you seen him block?
Have you seen Magic pass?
Well, then this will be a good matchup.
When the Pistons beat the Lakers, that's what they did. They put Rodman on Magic, and it slowed their whole offense down.
The Pistons?
Yeah.
Yes.
They had the Lakers had some problems in that game. They had people hurt. They had problems.
He's gonna have excuses for Magic. You know, it don't matter what we say.
The Lakers at their prime time, nobody could beat them. I mean, period. And they didn't. They only got beat when they had injuries and they got old and had injuries. And they still could have won with the oldness, but they couldn't win with the Worthy's couldn't play. Byron Scott was not even in the building. I mean, those were the Lakers. So he lost. You know, AC.
He don't want to accept it, so you know what he said?
Giannis can't stop Magic. That's what basically.
That's what you're trying to say right now.
No. That's what I'm saying.
Wingspan.
Yes, he can.
He's going to stop. That don't make no difference.
Yes,
That's like George Foreman going to whoop Ali. Look at all that stuff he had. Who had the brains?
Why'd you just go to boxing?
No, I'm just saying, you can't just go physically and look at a player. Look at Dwight Howard. He should be the greatest of all time.
Dwight Howard is soft.
But it's all in the mind. Yeah.
See, don't bring that softness up.
You gotta have that mind. Magic was a genius.
Okay. Anyways, okay. Magic and Giannis. What else? Who else?
So we'll call that even then. Because
we're gonna call it even.
But you can't just match him up there and call him this and that. Because, see, first of all, Giannis is not going to be guarding Magic. Worthy's going to set a screen. Giannis is going to be guarding Worthy.
No, you talking about these teams.
We talking about your team. Well, where are you getting worked at?
But I'm
Worthy.
You got it. You okay, Pops?
I was just giving you an example.
Wait.
I was giving you an example. I was giving you an example, but right. Hakeem is setting the screen for Magic.
That's what you did.
I used the wrong player, but the same theory.
No, it isn't.
When you set up the matchups, the first thing the coach does and the players like Magic, they eliminate the matchup. You eliminate that.
Cause a switch.
Yeah, it's a switch. Is he gonna fight? Is he gonna go over or behind or switch? What you gonna do? Giannis ain't gonna know what to do.
Well, I don't know
about that. We disagree.
This is what I'm thinking. He's gonna be confused.
And
by the time they figure it out, Magic is throwing the ball or shot at himself.
I'm gonna say Magic's basketball IQ is
off the charts.
One of the best of all time.
There you go.
Giannis is a physical. There's nothing like him.
There's nothing like Giannis.
But
he's gonna give you 20 boards. Yeah. Magic isn't gonna be down there doing that.
That's not his job.
But it's with this team that
we're coming up with. We're talking about this.
But if he's guarding Magic, he's not going to get that many boards. Magic is not even going to be by the basket.
Let's look at the rest of the team.
Yeah,
can we get past
Magic?
We got your past Magic.
Damn.
So, okay, we
got
Jordan.
You know Magic is going to have a documentary Kobe coming out.
You got Jordan.
That's going to be even. Right. Probably would give it to Jordan just because he's stronger. He could body up Kobe.
Kobe's a much better shooter than Jordan.
They're the same person.
So how would you give it to Jordan?
They the same people to me.
Because depending on the era,
I would give Kobe the advantage on that.
If it's modern era, I would say Kobe. But in Jordan's prime era, where you can body people.
Well, we got to pick one era now.
No, you said when everyone's at their best. Now, which one is it?
Physically.
Physically.
At their best. But down the rules now, we gotta pick a era, you know,
because that's what makes it.
This is gonna take like 2-3 episodes for us to get this.
No,
right.
We can get through this. We can get through. We're
not
there.
Gonna get through this.
But we can call that a wash because it kind of depends.
Yeah,
depends
you can call it that. You can call it that.
Because Jordan, he was jumping.
Okay, now I'm gonna tell you something though. You can call all of them a wash, really, if you really wanted to.
No, okay, who we putting Dennis Rodman against?
I'm not gonna have Duncan.
Hakeem? Are we putting
on
Dennis?
Hakeem. That ain't he's not gonna do nothing with Hakeem.
With Tim Duncan.
He ain't doing nothing with Hakeem.
That's what Hakeem would be doing, Duncan.
Wait a minute. Y'all said Duncan can't handle Hakeem?
Nah, that's not happening.
At their peak.
Giannis is not handling
at their peak, Hakeem.
Nobody on that team
Giannis
is handling him.
I'm gonna be honest with you, y'all right about Hakeem. I was about to try to find an argument.
He was just on a team with a whole bunch of shooters. Otherwise, he'd average 40, 30.
Did he finally get a ring, Hakeem?
He got two.
He got two, right.
Okay. I think in a row.
He got two.
It was Patrick
years
Ewing.
That Jordan was out.
Okay.
So, I'm gonna have to give Hakeem on that matchup. Going down to Dr. J on Durant.
I'm giving it to Dr. J.
I love Dr. J.
I'm giving it to Dr. J.
Innovated the game.
I'm giving it to Dr. J.
But he's doing nothing with a 7-footer that can shoot from anywhere on the court.
When he's healthy.
I mean, we're going to bring health into it.
When Kevin can play.
Everybody's
healthy. Everybody's in their prime. And ain't nobody getting hurt.
I'm going with Dr. J all day.
Yeah, you picked it. That's what you picked.
I would only go with Durant.
Well, I was
going to
say something else, but I'm with my family.
Okay.
Jay.
Are we done?
And then we got at center. I guess it's the center. Or maybe Tim Duncan's center.
Tim
we
Duncan.
We got Kareem.
Who's
Duncan was at center?
No, he was a forward.
Okay, so we got Rodman at center? Is that how we doing
No.
it? So we got Rodman on Hakeem. Now, what do you think about that, Dad?
Rodman on
Hakeem. Could Rodman do anything with the sky hook?
You could grab
you got Rodman on Kareem Abdul-Jabbar?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Rodman's going to foul out. Now so Rodman's not even playing. Now who you got bringing in? Iceman?
You got George Gervin.
You got George Gervin. You gonna bring him in on Kareem?
On Will.
Listen, that team has no chance against my team. Number one,
we had no chance. Period. You took everybody. You took Kobe.
I just took six people.
You took Kobe.
Six people.
I would have took Kareem.
I took six people. I mean, that's my team.
You did the.
Why are y'all doing this number 45 hand?
Okay, I tell you what. You want Kobe? You want me to give you Kobe?
Are you giving me Kobe?
I'll give you Kobe.
Okay.
And yeah. I take Jordan.
No, I want both.
Well, you can't have both. Okay, so.
All right, nah.
We'll have we're going to have the fans.
Who they think will
decide.
Win?
Yeah, they have to decide.
Well, I can tell you decide. Just on paper, the Hakeem and the Kareem and the Durant matchup, it's gonna be tough for Nola. It's gonna be tough.
Okay,
for
once again, what was Suave's team?
So I have a team. I had to
pick. Please tell me what his team was.
I had to pick.
Okay,
we'll do the same thing with Suave's
team. So
we're
gonna go with who's left.
Team.
No, you got to take some of her people. You got to make your own team. You got Michael Jordan. Okay, Suave.
So this is my starting five.
This is
you got
to beat to beat his.
To go baby boomer, generation X, and millennium.
This
sorry.
Is the millennials.
This is your
okay,
millennium.
X team. We have decided to let the fans decide. We've decided she's gonna lose. Nola J's team can't beat my team. I think she'll even admit that.
I won't. It wasn't fair.
Okay, then we'll let the people vote. Okay, now Suave's got
at the point,
LeBron James and Michael Jordan is
I had Jordan at the two.
You gonna have
Jordan's
to get Jordan
at the
out of
two.
Your, out of your
Dwight
spot.
Howard.
You went with Dwight Howard.
I went with Dwight Howard at the five.
Ooh, that's soft.
Okay, Dwight is the center. He got Dwayne Wade.
I got Dwayne Wade at the three.
You got him at the small forward.
Okay.
And Charles Barkley.
Charles Barkley.
I got
Bless your heart, hey, young man. No, Bless your heart.
Okay. All right. Now, wait a minute now.
It's basketball reasons for this.
And off the bench, he's got. Who is that off the bench?
Dennis Rodman.
You don't have a ball in there?
Well, at least he's got some centers.
You don't have your ball.
We got to go a couple more drafts before we get to Lonzo. Ball.
But you got to get Jordan out of there because I have Jordan.
Well, I no, picked no, the team just, against his team.
This is the
oh,
same.
I didn't know who you had.
Oh, so we're going against him again. Okay. Yeah.
You got to go,
but see, my team
you got to go
his
against
team.
The best.
You think your team will beat his team?
Yeah, my team will beat
okay,
his
Okay, let's
team.
Break
now,
it down.
His team, we might have to play a little harder, but we will beat them.
Okay, let's do the matchup. Let's do it. Come on.
Go with the Magic.
Break it down.
So we got LeBron on Magic.
You got LeBron on Magic. Okay.
Hmm.
Prime. So we're talking about Prime Magic versus Prime LeBron.
Prime.
Prime LeBron can shoot. Prime LeBron is way more athletic.
Hmm.
Prime Magic will probably make the better basketball
I'm for
decision.
Prime Magic. I'm sorry. This is between you two. My bad.
But... But see, the
no, he weighed in on yours.
Yeah,
so.
He did.
So, individually, I'll probably give that to LeBron. But for the team, Magic would probably have a better effect on if the team going against each other. But that's why I drafted Jordan at the two. Because Jordan, he's the killer. He's going to make sure that we win. He's going to get mad at somebody and take something personal. Like, oh, Kobe, he's copying me. I took it personal.
He's going to be petty, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we've got Dwayne Wade at the three. One of the best defensive shooting guards of all time.
Dwayne Wade?
Dwayne Wade.
Hold on. Did you fact check this?
Prime, look it up. Prime Wade was.
Look it up.
In the prime.
When they was prime, on the same team, two steals, good.
So there's no one else in the history of the NBA, you're saying?
Jordan.
Okay.
So defensively.
See? See what I mean?
What are you talking about?
Defense,
shooting guard.
Well, now you're talking about you forgetting about Oscar Robertson.
See what I mean?
And he's you're forgetting about what's his name? Elgin Baylor.
He's a small forward. I'm talking about shooting guards.
In this day and age, they would have been guards. They might have been forwards back then, but they would be guards now.
Well, he.
And they could dribble. They'll tell you themselves. The way that these guys dribble, or the way that all of them dribble, they would be called every play for carrying the ball. You can't put your hand under the ball. That's like cheating for real bad. Those guys actually could dribble.
Yeah.
Oscar Robertson could dribble on the floor like Curly at the Globetrotters. Those guys could handle the ball. They didn't step. They didn't travel. They didn't do all that stuff. But now you're going to let them do this with the new rules because we're going to play with the new rules.
Yeah, because if Wilt could Eurostep, it'd be a wrap.
Yeah. I'm just saying. These guys were better.
You can't say whole, them all time.
As a whole, individually, you got better. You got guys you can't say, you know.
But I drafted against your team, and I know we could put Wade on Durant, and that'll slow him down.
Yeah.
I know that. Okay. So that's why
It'll take him 7 seconds to make the shot instead of six.
Nah, they played. Now, Wade, in his prime, he had the 3 years where he was.
I agree with you, but I wouldn't say all time. You said all time.
Yeah, he's top three shooting guard defensively all time.
All time, throughout the whole entire NBA history.
Look up his numbers.
Okay,
steals,
we're going to fact check him.
Block shots. Look it up.
Well.
And then Barkley.
Yeah, so where did he come from?
Now, don't play Bradley cheap. Now, Bradley wasn't no joke. Now,
you talking about a dude.
Now, I fear this team more than I do your team.
Because, well, we're going to, because Jordan's going to be taking the shots. This is how I built the team. I got Dwight Howard at the five. Jordan's going to be taking shots. We need an offensive rebounder. And we need somebody that's going to get us easy buckets because. If they get a defensive rebound, it's going to be a wrap on a fast break with Magic. So we got to get Barkley in there to put his 280-pound behind down there on the block.
You didn't put, what about Shaq?
Shaq ain't running with that team. Shaq ain't doing nothing with Kareem.
Shaq is not on any.
He's not.
We're not putting Shaq on any team.
He ain't doing nothing with Will.
When you got legitimate centers. Shaq is a bust. He can't throw free throws. All you got to do is foul him and send him to the free throw line.
But Shaq was a good basketball player.
He was good.
I
put him behind probably all those centers that's been drafted.
Yeah, but he's behind all the centers. When you get down to the centers, he's not the first one. Shoot, you got, well, he might can compete with Bill Russell. That's about it. You know, the great centers.
But that's why I got Barkley. And he can stretch the floor because he can shoot.
He can run.
And we need somebody to get Akeem and Kareem out the paint. So he can shoot. And he can keep that paint wide open.
Hmm.
So that's why I got Barkley. And he's athletic. In his prime, he's going coast to coast, dunking on the fast.
I have a question mark on Barkley. But I hear you. I understand why you picked it.
And then at the five, I got Dwight Howard.
I don't know why you got his soft.
Because prime Dwight... He was dominant on defense. Completely dominant.
I don't know about that one.
Look it
listen.
Up. Grabbing people's shots from
probably,
the air.
He probably, but I don't think he...
Took that role-player team Magic to the finals. Almost won. Like, yeah, Dwight in his prime, people forget because he washed up now and he, you know, he be switching too.
Yeah, but I don't know what he's
his prime done. Only lasted a couple
That's
years.
That's what I mean. He's
but
not.
But the same thing with Wade. Same thing with
we
Wade.
Should, we should,
no, was, but Wade was different.
His real prime.
We should have made some kind of stipulation that prime should at least, you know, should.
Yeah, how many years?
Can't should be just one year.
Yeah, can't one, be just one year. Year. You know, that's like a fluke.
If that's the case, then I got Darwin Ham. From the Bucks a long time ago. Yeah.
But he's all defensive team like 10 years.
Okay, that's great.
And then I but got now
my, he's like, yeah, that's great.
My team, if you look at my team, these are all smart basketball players. I mean, high IQ in the top 10.
I have high IQ players.
High IQ. You have some questionable
people. Who's questionable? Who's dumb on my team? Oh, you gotta go get the ring glasses again.
You gotta say Giannis.
Ain't none of
Giannis is not dumb.
Nah, look, ain't none of them dumb. You don't be dumb to be on any of these teams.
They have high IQ.
But okay, Giannis. Well, no, his IQ is not up to par.
Yes, it is.
Tim Duncan.
Yes, Tim Duncan. Dr. J. Michael Jordan.
He actually only played on high IQ. He wasn't really a fantastic player. He was smart.
Yes, he was.
Jordan high IQ. Dr. J. He had a high IQ for scoring.
And he had a high
Q
and swag.
Dennis Rodman was just one of the smartest basketball players of all
time. I put him in the top three of one of the smartest Dennis Rodman.
And these guys really have high IQ.
They do.
These guys over here, IQs are off the chart.
Oh, of course they are.
You got Magic Johnson, probably the highest IQ of all basketball players. Kevin Durant, very high.
It's okay.
Kevin is very average.
Let's just say high.
No, you just saying that. No.
Hakeem, very high. Kobe, off the chart.
Yeah.
Kareem, off the chart. Wilt Chamberlain, off the chart. Okay, I got three or four off the chart.
No, you just got saying that.
You got
off the chart.
You guys got one off the chart. I guess you can give Dr. J off the chart. LeBron, very good.
LeBron is me?
Yeah. Very good, but not off the chart.
Yeah, it's off the charts.
No, not the charts.
I would box on LeBron.
It's Michael Jordan, you got
two. I don't think LeBron
two.
Is off the
okay,
charts.
You, I don't either.
It's but, some video.
No. Okay, we on the bowling. Yeah, two against, no. Okay, LeBron,
to watch some
LeBron very watch good. Out. Michael off the charts. Dwight.
Dwight Howard is an idiot.
No. This like his is offensive.
These guys are all both
Dwight,
sides.
Dwight Howard is an idiot.
These are both sides. These are both side players. You could take a one-sided player and he's not off the charts. You know, you take Wade, he's off the charts with both sides, okay? Barkley,
you know damn well. He ain't got IQ, you know damn
he's
well.
There for rebound.
We talking about basketball IQ.
No,
we talking about basketball IQ now. We
okay, because I was about to say.
I mean, yeah, he
see, y'all treat him like, yeah. Barkley.
I think Barkley's pretty high.
If it weren't for Jordan, he'd have
Barkley had a pretty high basketball IQ, but he wasn't off the chart.
He didn't care about.
Okay, so
and you got is that Rodman?
It's Rodman.
Rodman's off the charts IQ.
Okay, so let's bring this all together. So we gonna let the people, the listeners, choose.
So does the baby boomer team with Magic,
Gen X, or the Millennium?
Kobe, Durant, Hakeem, Kareem, and Wilt coming off the bench with 100 points.
Which makes no sense. None.
Or the Generation X team with. I guess we got Giannis at the point, Jordan, Dr. J, Tim Duncan, and Dennis Rodman. Hope he doesn't get the ball on offense. And then my team, I just picked whatever was left.
No, you didn't. No, you. Oh, yeah, now, that's Jordan. Not true. You got to pick
Rodman.
Anybody you wanted. You took Michael Jordan from her team.
And Rodman. Okay,
and you got Rodman.
You took Rodman.
So you, now, that's your team.
But I had LeBron. I had Jordan. I had Wade at the three. I had Charles Chuck Barkley at the four. Dwight Howard at the five. And Rodman coming off the bench. Because he can guard all five.
I noticed something about you young kids.
Okay.
Teams.
What?
You went, like he said, you're comparing this and that and this and that.
What is this and that?
Well, like LeBron can, I got LeBron on Magic. And he's going to do this. The matchup.
It's a matchup. Game of matchup.
Okay. Mine. I don't care who you have on your team.
Okay.
I have everything I need. And the matchup, if they don't fit my team, if your matchup is better than mine on a particular player, I'm changing it. He's not going to be guarding him.
So what we're saying is the overall, we're not matching up. You say you don't want to match up.
You're matching up player for player. I'm matching up the team. You can't beat this team.
But that's because you pick
the best player of all time.
And we got expansion
and
teams.
We got Dwight Howard. You know it's sad out here.
Trying to beat you.
No, that's because I had to go with Dwight Howard. Yes, you're right. I did pick the best player.
So we got expansion
and you can't find a team that now I could. I could find a team
so
that
who
could
would
beat
you draft
these.
To beat your team.
That had to be on another show.
Okay, we'll put it on the next episode.
I could do it. But see, my team's got heart. All my players got heart. You know, the weakest guy on my team with heart is Kevin Durant.
He's the weakest, and, period.
We're talking about heart.
I'm talking about killer. I'm talking about killer.
All Jordan got to do is say something.
All my guys are killers. They all have that killer
Not
instinct.
Not Kevin Durant.
I said he's the only one.
He's just a snake.
You got a bunch of Kevin Durants on your team.
No, I do not have a bunch of Kevin Durants. No,
you don't have a bunch of killers. Dwight Howard.
He's not touching the ball. On defense, he's good, but he's not touching the ball on offense.
Actually, you got some killers, too.
I got killers. Right. You just hating on my team. I got killers. You baby boomers are bullies.
You got a couple of Tim Duncan.
Tim Duncan's a beast. I don't care what no one says.
Tim Duncan's a soldier.
Okay. Everyone wants a soldier.
Yeah, but you got to have a soldier with heart. I have the best.
What's going on? These guys, your heart?
These guys here, my guys are not going to, each one of them, you know, like they say, Jordan's not going to let us lose. Well, I got a whole team of guys that's not going to let you lose.
You got
Kevin Durant will let you lose.
Well,
Kevin Durant will leave and go and get a ring. Don't go there with Kevin Durant.
My team got enough heart that the droppings and the leftovers that Kevin's gonna just fall into is just gonna make him have heart. You know what I'm saying? He ain't gonna have no choice.
Why do you like Kevin Durant so much?
He's a bad dude.
Can you break it down? Because he's hurt the majority of time. So break down. What is so great about him?
Well,
I know he's been in the lead. I just want to hear him break down Kevin Durant to me.
There's not anything that he can't do. He's like Magic Johnson that can't play center. That's it. He can point guard. He can shoot.
No, he can
go to any of these guys can bring the ball down and pass it.
That's
unless you're what's the guy with Magic? Byron Scott is the only guy I know that you can just take the ball from him. If you can't take the ball from him, you can a point guard. All he has to do is get the ball down to the half court. That's all he got to do. What's so hard about that?
Well,
that's why you got all these point forwards.
Traditionally, the point guard kind of brings it up.
Yeah,
that's all he does. He brings the ball down.
Nowadays. The point guard has to be able to just get a break down the offensive player, get a bucket, or set up a teammate like the Derrick Roses, the Gilbert Arenas.
The point guard really don't do that. The team does that. The team is moving. When Magic Johnson was playing,
he came
down.
You don't call this a Magic Johnson episode.
Now listen, but this is what this is
an hour and a half on Magic. This is how all it's about.
This is how I learned what a point guard did. Before that, Magic. I didn't even know there was a point guard.
You really didn't?
No, I just thought there's two guards. You know, one of them shoots a lot. You know, that's
the shooting guard.
Shooting guard shot a lot, but I didn't know why. You know, and I don't know why this guy. But see, back then you had to be able to dribble. You know, because if you didn't, the guy guarding you.
What year are you talking about?
I'm talking basketball. The guy guarding you would take the ball from you. Or disrupt you so much, you're stuck. You got to pass the ball regardless of where everybody's at. Somebody got to run to you so you can throw the ball. When I saw Magic play, Magic came down. Okay, you can put Rodman, you can put Giannis, you can put anybody on him. They're not taking the ball from him. And he's still going to the spot he wants to go to. He's going to do that. And you don't know where he's going to throw the ball. If he looks that way, your best chance is to look the other way, because that's where the ball probably is going. You know, Giannis, he'll be trying to figure out. I can hear him not going.
No, you can't hear him say anything, because Giannis is very intelligent. And I appreciate you not to be talking about Giannis like that, okay? Because he would know exactly what to do. And stop giving all his credit to Magic.
First of all, that'd be the first time he played against Magic, so he'll really have no clue.
Yes, he will have a clue.
The first half, he'll be going, Coach, I think I got it.
No, he studies basketball. He knows what he's doing. He's going to have it the first minute.
And I'll tell you a secret, too, about my team.
Oh, you got a secret now?
Well, basketball people know it, but some people seem to not know that.
Oh, okay.
Magic Johnson. His shooting average is very high. Very high. He can shoot really good.
Oh.
You know.
Okay.
And all in all, when everything breaks down, when they actually fall off of Magic and try to
pull up numbers in real time.
Huh?
We gotta pull up numbers in real time.
Yeah, we're gonna fact check.
Look at that. What is that?
Okay, so all right, before we go off the rails, we're gonna wrap this up. So what we're gonna do is next week we're gonna figure out what the listeners and the fans felt.
Yeah, I wanna know what they think.
And then we're going to figure out next week what you guys wanna figure out. You wanna continue with basketball or do you wanna go into football? Are we good enough in football?
We're not ready for football.
We're not ready for football? You wanna
Well, when y'all get ready, let me know.
Well, I'm ready because I watch football. Swizzle, what's going on with Millenniums? Y'all don't do football?
We on a strike.
What strike you on?
I mean, until, you know.
No, I'm saying our top five, I don't know, maybe teams or players or quarterbacks. Teams. Or we got to figure out the next one. So we'll figure out what we're going to do next episode.
But right now, it's still basketball. Well, yeah,
let's worry about that when we get done with the basketball.
Yeah.
I want to know what all seven of your fans think about this.
I got, 10.
But what we can do is I can load these teams up in NBA 2K and see how they
So we're going to play a game next episode?
I mean, we're going to play it. We just watch and see what happens.
Yeah, we can do that. We need to do some research, too. I'm going to start. Well, we got to go back and look at some YouTubes.
I tell you what. Let the fans decide that. And then if it's close, if they don't pick my team to win, we're going to have them analyze. No. What we'll do, we'll go with the rest of the team. What we got? 10 players on the team.
You're going to draft the whole roster?
I'll show you my other bench, my bench players, like Scottie Pippen and all those other guys, you know,
we'll
LeBron. Oh, y'all got him already, huh? You know, Sam Perkins, Moses Malone, you know, y'all should have picked. Because the only guy that gave Kareem any trouble. Was Moses Malone.
Uh-huh. You're right.
But that was in his prime, and that was those rules. I don't know what rules you're going to go with. Because you go with the rules nowadays.
These rules won't
make a difference. But back then, they let Moses push Kareem around.
So what rules should we go with? Should we just go at their prime, whatever their rules were, right?
Well,
everybody's prime is a different time.
That's what I mean. Yeah. So whatever the rules were,
go with these rules now.
These rules are soft as hell.
These rules now, you put Wilt out there, you might as well just cancel Christmas.
Yeah.
Because there's nothing anybody can do. he starts Euro-stepping.
Any of these guys on my team, what are you talking about?
Okay, just Wilt. We know about
Kareem really would be the killer. Because the thing that he had, the power he had that Kareem didn't have, would be nullified. So that would make Kareem way over Wilt. You know? Because Kareem, if you didn't touch him, I mean, you know, he just skyhook you all day long.
All right. Well, on the next episode, we're going to continue this debate.
I have Michael Cooper on my team.
So we're going to wrap this up, and we're going to follow up on next episode. So this is our first episode of The Generation Gap.
With the basketball theme on Father's Day.
It was all about pops. It's all about pops.
And I think we should talk about a lot of different things.
Oh yeah, we got a lot of stuff besides basketball that we want to talk about.
Maybe get into some music.
Yes.
Get into maybe some other topics things are going on right now that we all would have different, maybe the same perspective.
I don't know what happened to Lamar Jackson. I don't know what happened to that man. I mean,
That last game,
man. It's something. We got to talk about if the games are that much fixed now that they're already predetermined, and who's all involved in it.
And we're gonna have to talk about the little July 22nd start date of the NBA that's coming up.
Are they gonna do it?
Yeah, they're gonna be in Disney World in a bubble.
But on the plan, so Kyrie Irving, is he?
I don't know what he's doing.
He's speaking for 100 players. We're not playing.
I don't know if he's speaking for 100. You keep saying that because I'm hearing other players saying like he's not speaking for us. So we'll discuss all that next time. We're going to end this one. This is our first episode of the Generation Gap.
We got raw and uncut. This one was clean.
Yeah, it was real clean.
It was real clean.
That's because I think Pops was here.
Well, y'all did another one?
He's always going to be here. So
maybe we'll spice it up.
We'll
spice it up in the future.
No, we should keep everything wholesome and clean. You know, I just get, dirty around my kids. What kind of image is that?
This is how we was made.
What kind of people
we was
are
made
you?
By dirt. We was made by smut. I'm a groupie, people. Baby.
That's
a whole other episode.
We got two Borden milk babies and a breastfed, and you still came out like that.
Yeah. So, okay, we're going to end this. So, we got Baby Boomer, Millennium, and Generation X. And next week, we will be back. I am Nola J, a.k.a. Chocolate Blonde, a.k.a. Jizzle, a.k.a. Gen X, baby.
Yeah, all that.
And watch some Laker Bull tapes before they won the champ. Before the Bulls won their first championship, watch some of those videos. I think you need to reiterate your thoughts on Magic Johnson, the real GOAT.
Dad, are you happy next year they're going to finally have a Magic Johnson documentary?
No, because they've already been paid off. They're not going to make it better than Michael's.
Here we go.
And I'm your co-host, Don Suave, a.k.a. Swizzy Suave, a.k.a. Suave Sutra, a.k.a. the Caramel Don, a.k.a.
Moosehead.
All right, see, I let that happen.
Dad,
okay.
You want to get out or you done with us?
I'm out.
All right, you guys.
Generation Gap.
It's Generation Gap. You guys have a good week. Thanks for listening. We appreciate it. Peace out. Deuces. When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions, like how do I record an episode, how to get my show into all the apps people like to listen to, how do I make money from this podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is really simple, Anchor. Anchor is the one-stop shop for recording, hosting your podcast. Best of all, it's 100% free, and it's ridiculously easy to use. Even my chocolate blonde self can use it. And now Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid to podcast right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad. I love it. It's simple. You know, I'm an airhead, so I just put things together, has all the tools you need. I can distribute this to all kind of platforms. I'm on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, wherever you listen to your podcast, you can have your podcast there. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. I can't wait to hear your podcast.
Tell a friend to download and subscribe to the No Reason Podcast with Nola J, the Chocolate Blonde. Go to the website nolajcomedy.com. That's nolajcomedy.com.